Test. It was on. Well, good evening, and welcome to our Gems of the Baroque. Tonight you're going to hear some very racy music, I must say. I didn't put the translations in because I didn't want people sweating and having to fan themselves. So I'll tell you just a little bit. Our first number that we will sing is an opening prayer. It's by Vittoria, and it's a beautiful motet. And I think you'll really enjoy it. We would like to dedicate this to Dr. Francis and her family on the recent passing of her father. So that's something that's very important to us, and it's a beautiful piece, and it's really talking about Jesus's time before that and into Easter weekend. The next set that we'll do is basically the beginning of the Baroque era. And it is pieces by Monteverdi, and they're part of his madrigals. Madrigals at this time are supposed to be extraordinarily expressive, and many of them were a little bit racy. You'll hear us sing in Italian, and the Italian basically translates to longing and passionate love. And we have three of these pieces that will, through the music, you will hear the desire and the love that is very passionately expressed in the way the notes are put together. And then we'll move on to a piece from Handel, who's also from the later Baroque. And finally, we'll finish with a Buxtehude piece, and at that time, I'll invite the orchestra to come out and play with us. So we hope you have a very good first half, and after the half, we're going to take just a 3-minute break to switch choirs, and then we'll come on and sing the Vivaldi Gloria for you. We hope you have a wonderful evening. If you could take just a moment and silence your cell phones, please no flash photography during the concert. We would like the singers to be able to see their music so that they can perform it well for you. And we really enjoyed putting this music together. We hope you have an excellent time and get to know a little of the splendor that was Baroque music.
Thank you. by the rhythms of the natural language. So what the singers see on the page is literally like this big double whole note, and all the words are printed underneath it. So we have learned to speak it together. We hope you enjoy Sfogava con le stelle.
Thank you.
we are so fortunate to be able to have them join us for these Baroque pieces. There's a marriage, you know, string music really string music really comes into its own during the Baroque. Prior to that, a lot of the music that was written for strings and for other instruments were done so basically to accompany. But once we get to the Baroque period, a lot of the repertoire diversifies and music's written specifically for strings. And so this was probably written in mind for strings. Buxtehude was a German composer. A funny story is you all have heard of Johann Sebastian Bach, right? Yes, Dr. St. Maria, I took your music history class, right? And he was a famous composer, and he got his first job at the age of 18. He was going to be the organist and choir director at a church in Arnstadt. And within the first 2 weeks, he goes to his employers and he says, you know, I want to take a vacation, and I want to go see Buxtehude play, and this is to the next piece we are. And they said, okay, you can go for a little while and then come back. It was quite a long trip, probably the longest trip Bach ever took in his life. And he was supposed to stay a couple weeks. He stayed almost 6 months. Ooh. I know, and he had his job when he came back. That's how great a composer he was and great an organist he was. They were not too happy, but you know, he got to keep his job. So this is the composer that he went to see that he thought was so important in his contemporary composers, and this is Dietrich Buxtehude. My name. Thank you. Before these jokers leave the stage, I just want to say that we just got back from a trip, and we had two of our students. One's on stage now, and I hope they're getting the other one, but Darius should come down, who went to the National Association for Teachers of Singing, and Aaron placed into the semifinals. And Darius, who might be backstage, I'm not sure, placed first in his category in the finals. So he's probably doing the finals. I'll point him out when he comes out for the second half. So we'll just take a 5-minute little stretch your legs thing, and then the second choir will be back to do the glory. Thank you. So this next half is actually one piece. You hear it, if you go to the Catholic Mass, you hear the entire choir every time. Now this one's split into a whole bunch of movements, and it's about 28 minutes. And it's a beautiful rendition by Vivaldi. Vivaldi was called Il Prete Rosso, which means he was the red-haired priest. He became a priest, and he was a very famous composer at the time. And actually, he was a virtuoso violinist. And he kind of had an affair with a woman who had children. And for this, the Pope banned him from playing solo-wise in any of the papal lands, which is a big part of Europe at the time. And so he wound up teaching at the Pietà di Ospitale, which is an orphanage for young girls. And he wound up having the greatest orchestra in all of Italy. But the girls could not play in person, so they put up a screen, and every when they put on concerts, people would come to the courtyard and they would listen to them through the screen, because girls at the time were not allowed to do music in person. And I don't know why that was, but that's the way it was at the time. So this is a beautiful piece, and it was written for his choirs and orchestra there, and it's one of the staples of the Baroque literature.